Greetings, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome back to the Azure Seas of a still unknown planet. I am Der Heizmeister, and this is what I announced in the last build episode. As requested by Demodog, this is the duel of the battleships, the SMS Caledonia versus the Corollus Rex. Mark III. This duel will take place on this unknown planet in a special arena prepared for this exact event. Now then, before we head off into the battle arena, let's take a look at the contestants first and see what both of them have to offer. Coming in at 1.5 million materials, it's the Lion from the North, it's the Corollus Rex Mark III. This battleship is built in a style of a French battleship, actually, like the Richelieu, for example. Now then, this ship also is equipped with a lot of guns, firepower in every direction. Its main weapons are two forward-facing, four-barreled, kinetic hollow point guns, and these are also raid assisted, delivering a deadly salvo for anything that crosses its arc. The Corollus Rex Mark III is also equipped with anti-air lasers and a lot of secondaries, as well as two powerful Sievers emplacements. Actually, make that four powerful Sievers emplacements. It is also heavily shielded, heavily armored, and has a strong lamps. This will be a tough nut to crack for any ship. However, let's take a look at the other contestant, the Caledonia. Coming in at 1.3 million materials, it's kills and cannons, it's the Caledonia. This battleship is a little bit of an all-rounder, being the flagship of the naval branch of the Cosmomarina. Equipped with not only powerful APS guns, it has a little bit of everything. Simple weapons, casemates, and missiles, more missiles, torpedoes, anti-air lasers, and Sievers. The main armament consists of three turrets, each sporting three kinetic hollow point rail-assisted APS guns for maximum firepower at even longer ranges. The laser systems here are specialized to intercept and suiciding nuke drones or even aircraft. As well as with these casemates delivering a secondary salvo, the main focus of this battleship is, as I said, being an all-rounder, practically engaging any type of target. Not specialized towards one role, a jack of all trades, but master of none. However, it is now time to prepare the arena for this duel of the titans. Let's head on in the arena. And here we are, ladies and gentlemen, in the battle arena. Now, before we start this fight, I will go over the rules just very quickly. Each team will be spawned 1200 meters apart from each other, facing each other, of course, and each team will have 500,000 materials allocated to their storage. There will be 0.05 salvage per destroyed material, and the disqualification and the victory rules are as follows. A ship has won when it has managed to get its opponent below 55% health, and this opponent is therefore declared too damaged, or if the opponent's AI has been destroyed. Also, a ship has won when the opponent has no guns left and it is incapable of fighting back. Repairs can only sustain a construct in play for 50 seconds. And if your opponent is below 80% health and sinking, he is also declared destroyed. If for some reason one ship manages to sink and is not at 80% health, it will be allocated some penalty points for not maintaining a altitude above minus 25 meters. This battle will take 9 minutes, and after 9 minutes, the winner will be announced. The winner is the one who has the most health points left. The health points being relative, course, in percentage. Now then, the teams are set up. Team number one, consisting of the Carolus Rex Mark III here in the left corner, sporting the fleet colors of the Grey Talons. Team 2 is the GasBB Caledonia, sporting the fleet colors of the Redacted Forces. Alright, ladies and gentlemen, I guess both teams are ready, and it is time to fight. And with that, we are ready. Ladies and gentlemen, assume battle stations, load your cannons. This fight will begin in 3, 2, 1, fight! And the opponents have spawned in and are exchanging their first opening salvos, both ships facing each other, and immediately two front guns are unleashing a salvo of kinetic death. The Caledonia here picking up speed while launching its missile barrage. The missile barrage, however, being intercepted by the powerful lamps of the Carolus Rex Mark III. Now then, as the two duelists are assuming broadside positions, all guns are ready to fire. On the Caledonia, these are the three main turrets, and on the Carolus Rex Mark III, these are those two forward-facing four-barreled main guns. Both opponents now passing each other as they further exchange some salvos, and there is an explosion and block confetti on the Carolus Rex. I can see the engine and the rear guns. What has happened there? Looks like a devastating strike delivered by the Caledonia. How's it looking on the other side? There are torpedoes coming in. Intercepted, however. Well done. The Caledonia seems to have taken damage around its her armor belt. But so far it looks like all other systems are still functioning. Now then, both ships are now assuming their respective combat position and distances as they drive away from each other. The Seabus of the Carolus Rex still intercepting missiles as well as torpedoes. Speaking of torpedoes, there is one salvo of torpedo interceptors released, and they will attempt to intercept the large interceptor, not the interceptors, the large torpedoes from the Caledonia. Oh, what is going on? The armor belt of the Carolus Rex now severely damaged. Missiles incoming. The Seabus doesn't have the time or the power to intercept them all, and interceptors here not managing to catch them. This is not looking good for the Carolus Rex. But how is it looking for the Caledonia? Well, she has taken a few scratches here and there. She is now at 89.8%, while the Carolus Rex is at 95%. Still, both ships are completely fully armed and operational, and still firing away at longer ranges. As you can see here, the Lambs is trying to intercept some of the shots from the Carolus Rex, however failing to do so, and many of them land a hit on the Caledonia's armor belt. Missiles once again away and tracking. All the while, the Carolus Rex is firing away with its main turrets, truly devastating kinetic guns. Equipped with hollowpoint warheads that apply their thump damage to large chunks of armor. Speaking of large chunks of armor, what has happened? The armor belt of the Carolus Rex has been breached. I can see the internals now. And as it seems, several guns have been disabled. The Carolus Rex is at 92%, while the Caledonia remains at 89%, with 0.7% as well. Still, the main gun on the Carolus Rex still operational, as are some of the defensive systems. Under the waves, there is quite some turmoil going on as interceptors and torpedoes try to get the upper hand. torpedoes being intercepted, and therefore more interceptors being launched as more torpedoes are being picked up. Another missile salvo has hit the Carolus Rex, and how does it look on the side of the Caledonia? Still, the armor belt has been peeled off on some places. One main gun has been damaged as its barrel has been sheared off. Still, she is mostly functional with one anti-aircraft gun now being a little bit unfortunate as it is not operational anymore. And as the shells whiz by, I can see now that another missile salvo is coming in, and the Lambs and Cebus doing their very best to intercept this one. However, it is not looking good for the Carolus Rex Mark III right now. One of its main guns had received a hit, and I correct myself here, two of their main guns have received a hit, and they are now each missing one barrel. However, the secondaries are still operational and flinging copious amounts of Dukkha in the direction of the Caledonia. With more interceptors being launched, and I cannot see any torpedoes coming in from the Caledonia now. Looks like those interceptors are doing the job just fine. Now then, another missile salvo coming in. However, the Lambs and the Cebus seems to have this one under control. Or maybe not. Two missiles striking home. Three missiles striking home. Interceptors being launched there a little bit too late. Still, these two Titans continue to circle each other while exchanging salvos of APS fire as well as missiles. And here is the small missile barrage from the Caledonia. Watch out for this one. This one is loaded with frag and copious amounts of EMP, capable of damaging local weapon controllers, detection systems and Lambs nodes, and potentially disabling the opponent. And here are some more large missiles coming in. The Caledonia is equipped with numerous weapon systems, and it shows now that those numerous weapon systems will find a way to strike home. The Carolus Rex Mark III now, albeit severely damaged, still in the fight. And what is this? I can't believe it! One turret has been shot off and an explosion has ripped a hole into the bottom of the Carolus Rex Mark III. Sorry there, ladies and gentlemen. One main gun missing and the Carolus Rex slowing down as this turret is ejected. Still, he is not out of the fight yet. He is still firing. The Caledonia now managed to heal herself up, almost up to 100% again. And this battle is not over yet, although it is not looking good for the Carolus Rex Mark III. Although he is still fighting, has received some substantial damage, I have to say. I can see the Lambs, the engine base, and I can also see the magazine through here. Oh boy, this could be over in just a second. Still, a little bit more than 5 minutes on the clock, and the two opponents are still very much capable of fighting. The Caledonia a little bit more so, as she is at 99%. The Carolus Rex, albeit being damaged and down to 69% now, still in the fight, as some of his guns are still blazing away. Another small missile salvo out from the Caledonia, and now on its way to their target. All the while, it seems that the holes in the armor have been repaired. So then, let's see how the Carolus Rex is faring so far. Still, torpedo interceptors are on their way to intercept the two large torpedoes of the Caledonia. Meanwhile, it doesn't look like any gun on the Carolus Rex is firing anymore. Oh no, I was mistaken. One main gun is still active. And I retract my previous statement. The last of the main guns have been detonated. And now the Carolus Rex is in serious problems right now. Let's see if there are any weapon systems still active. However, with the detonation of this main gun, the Carolus Rex has lost a chunk of its health points. And I fear this is the end of the battle, while the Caledonia, though guzzling through materials, has repaired herself up to 99.8%. Well, it is not looking good for the Carolus Rex, though he has fought a valiant battle, with all of its guns now destroyed and one side of armor, may I say, severely sheared off. And this is it, we are below 55% and the Carolus Rex is declared too damaged. And this is a win for the Caledonia. I can't believe it. One Titan of the Seas has been defeated. And here we have it, the winner of this round is the battleship Caledonia, as she has won by a knockout. Carolus Rex Mark III fought valiantly, but ultimately was defeated by her superior firepower. Now then, it's time for round two. Let's see if the Carolus Rex can turn this one around, as this battle is a best of three. Let's see if the next duel will take a different turn this time. Once again, back for round two. Both duelists have entered the battlefield and are now ready to duke it out a second time. So then, let's begin. In 3, 2, 1, fight! Both ships once again facing each other, firing off their initial salvos, and I immediately see some shells from the Carolus Rex striking home on the Caledonia's bow. The Caledonia itself launching her large heat torpedoes. They are on track to the target, however, being intercepted by the Carolus Rex interceptors. In turn, the torpedoes of the Carolus Rex being distracted by decoys and intercepted as well. Now then, both main guns are now on target and firing away, as well as are the secondaries of the Carolus Rex. The Seabees doing good work there, as well as the Lang systems intercepting most of the missile salvo, however some missiles still striking home. Now then, as the battle will go on, the Lambs will be depleted of its power and the engine has to struggle to fill it up back up again, as it cannot fill the Lambs system and the laser cavities up in an instant. The Seavis now being exposed as armor is being sheared away on the Carolus Rex. However, this Seavis is still fully operational. Or maybe not. What is happening there? Is it in a reload cycle? I do not know. Still, missile interceptors being launched by the Carolus Rex, and it looks like one of the main gun turrets has taken damage, and once again I am mistaken, two of the main gun turrets have taken damage. They are down one barrel. On the other side of the battlefield we can see the Caledonia receiving some hits, and oh, I can't believe it, the Caledonia has lost one of her main guns. It is completely inoperable. One barrel missing and two barrels being reduced to their minimal gauge. All the while, one other gun turret is dangerously exposed here. The turret neck could be sheared off at any second, and sheared off it did! One gun barrel missing, one gun barrel being shortened a little bit. This is not looking good this time. The Carolus Rex is pounding away on the Caledonia. And it looks like in this round the Caledonia seems to be on the receiving end of the Dakar being flung by the Carolus Rex. Now then, both contestants are at 97% and almost at the same level. However, the Caledonia has dropped to 96.9%. The Carolus Rex is in the lead right now. And as you can see here, two main guns being operational, one main gun being severely crippled, and it doesn't look like the Caledonia will recuperate from this one. If she can repair the main guns, then that is just fine. She needs those guns to deliver some well-needed firepower on the Carolus Rex Mark III. The Carolus Rex in turn being hit, and it seems another main gun has been damaged, now only emitting half its firepower, or maybe not, as I can see some barrel and firing pieces poking out right there. However, the loss in accuracy will be a detriment to the Carolus Rex. Once again, the Seabees is doing overtime on the Carolus Rex, intercepting most of those missile salvos being aided by the Lambs. now with all secondaries on one side bearing down on the Caledonia, and as well as the main guns, I think this could be the turning point in this battle now. Both contestants still at the same percentage of health. Now then, although the Carolus Rex has anti-aircraft lasers, I think they are not so useful in this battle as there are no aircraft present. The same goes for the Caledonia. Her anti-aircraft lasers will not be of much use here. Well, unless the Carolus Rex starts flying for some reason, but I doubt that he is going to do that. Well, let me just say, there are still two, well, not maybe two, 1 2/3 of main guns operable. However, the aft main gun is dangerously exposed and I can see inside the Caledonia's internals, well, at least a little bit. Looks like some armor has been sheared off and is now dangerously thin in some places. A torpedo from the Carolus Rex approaching the Caledonia. This is a frag torpedo, a large one at that, and it is getting dangerously close. However, it seems to be damaged and therefore its propulsion is being damaged as well and slowed down, intercepted in the last second. Another torpedo coming in and intercepted as well. Both duelists now at 95%. This is a, well, should I say, neck-to-neck battle. Oh boy, here we have it. The Carolus Rex main armament now reduced to half of its effectiveness. Well, oh, once again, I am mistaken apparently. It seems there are some gun barrels still functioning. However, they have been sheared off to a degree where the accuracy probably produces a lot of missing shots there. This is getting very dangerous. The Caledonia now at 94%. 94.9. All the while the Carolus Rex has managed to maintain most of its materials. As you can see here on the material gauge, the Caledonia is guzzling through materials in its attempt to defeat this Titan of the Seas, the Carolus Rex Mark III. Once again, missiles coming in, and not all of them could be intercepted. Some of them have hit on the main structure, on the main gun turret, and sheared off some barrels. Interceptors out from the Carolus Rex. Too late, I'm afraid. How's it looking on the other side? It seems that the Caledonia has received substantial damage to her bow and to her main armor belt as well. The rear main gun is almost inoperable, only one barrel missing. However, the lamps seems to have saved her from further damage, as it seems. Many shells being intercepted there. And still, the both duelists are still, well, up to the same percentage of health once again. This is truly exciting. I cannot believe at this point, I cannot think of any way this battle could go other way, as it seems that I cannot predict the outcome of this battle, just yet at least. Still, the Carolus Rex Mark III has many guns operational, all the while the Caledonia has not so many guns operational. Her main firepower stems from the three main guns, one of which has been disabled and the other one is severely crippled. Its performance has therefore diminished. Missiles being reloaded and now fired. I wonder if the Carolus Rex can intercept this salvo, as these missiles pack quite a lot of EMP and are therefore very useful in disabling their opponents' weapon systems, lamps and sensors. Missiles coming in here and being intercepted by the Seabiss. The Carolus Rex now slightly ahead at 94%, all the while the Caledonia is at 93.8%. Oh, nasty hit on the armor belt of the Carolus Rex there. However, it seems like I can once again see the internals of the Carolus Rex here and there. I wonder how this goes, though it seems that at this point in the battle, none of the main guns is being destroyed, and therefore no major holes are being poked into the Carolus Rex. Bottom. Oh boy, that sounded wrong. All guns once again blazing away on the Carolus Rex. Clearly the superior firepower here. It could have been a lucky hit delivered by the Caledonia in the first round. However, it seems that her luck has run out now. The second gun turret has been disabled. Now only left one main gun. Well, I say disabled, it's still firing. However, with these short barrels, this is not much use as the accuracy will be terrible. Missile interceptors also being destroyed there. Also one, although only one row of interceptors still remaining. And it looks like this could be it for the Caledonia. However, both duelists are still at the same percentage of health. Neither of them is gaining an advantage over the opponent. And if they do, this advantage is quickly nullified by the other one catching up and doing a lot of damage. It doesn't look like we can observe any torpedo strikes as the torpedo interception systems are working perfectly on both ships. However, the constant stream of firepower delivered by the Carolus Rex is surely tiring out the lamps on the Caledonia. Missiles being intercepted much more reliably now. Looks like the Caledonia has run out of luck when it comes to missile strikes. Not even her small missile batteries are landing a hit right now. The Sievers on the Carolus Rex doing a fine work there, supplemented by the power of his powerful lamps. Oh, what is this? It looks like one gun turret has been disabled, and it is a main gun at that. Oh no, this isn't looking good. Could this be the turning point of the battle? The Caledonia is slightly ahead now. 0.4%, 0.5%, 0.4% in health. I have no idea what's going on right now. And it seems that battle has progressed so far that we are now in the last minute of this battle. Now the decision has to be made. Both contestants are still firing, both contestants are still standing. Well, or more, should I say, floating. It is down to the percentage of health to determine who will be the winner of this battle. Can the Carolus Rex in the last 30 seconds of this battle still snatch victory? It doesn't look like it. He is at 91.6% and 91.5% at the Caledonia, 92.9%. This is absolutely close here. And all the while the armor belt of the Carolus Rex has been peeled away now. Looks like its early advantage has run out. And this could be it. The last 15 seconds. The last 10 seconds. 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, and that's it. Time over. And here we have it, gentlemen, at the 9-minute mark, and we have 5 seconds left. The Carolus Rex is at 90.9% of its health, all the while the Caledonia at 92.9% of her health. And, well, although it doesn't look good for both ships have received a lot of damage. It seems that in this very close fight, the Caledonia managed to come out on top, giving her 2 of 3 possible victories. And this means, in a best out of 3, the Caledonia has won this duel of the Titans on the seas. My congratulations to the victor, and well fought to the Carolus Rex Mark III here on the arena of this still unknown planet. Alright then, ladies and gentlemen, the duel has concluded, the winner being the battleship Caledonia, although the last battle was extremely close. Now then, ladies and gentlemen, if you would like to have a hand at those two battleships yourself, it will cost you nothing. I'll accept a small subscription on the Steam Workshop. Links are to those two workshop pages are in the description. Very well, I hope you enjoyed this little duel of two large titans of the seas, and I am der Heizmeister, now signing off from the Azure Seas of a still unknown planet. Good night and good fight.